What's up, everybody? It's your girl, Gossip Goddess, coming at you with a fresh dose of gossip for the day. Before we get started, guys, do me a favor and click that like button for me. And don't forget to subscribe and hit that notification bell so you don't miss any of this hot tea, honey. Now let's get into it. So as we know, Bobby Brown Jr., son of R&B singer Bobby Brown, passed away last November of 2020. Well, his autopsy report has finally been released and does confirm that Bobby Brown Jr. did in fact die from a combination of alcohol, cocaine, and the drug fentanyl. At this time, the Los Angeles District Attorney is opening a criminal investigation and is reportedly questioning Bobby Brown Jr.'s ex-girlfriend and others who were around him shortly before his passing. First off, let me just say my heart goes out to Bobby Brown, being that this is the second loss of a child that he has had to experience. As we all know, Bobby Brown did lose his daughter Whitney Houston, Bobby Brown Christina, back in 2015 from what was believed to be an overdose, which led to her being found face down in a bathtub of water, which then later turned into pneumonia 6 months after she was put into a coma. Bobby Brown and Kim Ward, mother of Bobby Brown Jr., seem to be having some skepticism behind the death of their son. Kim Ward made a comment that Bobby Brown Jr. was not into drugs, but he was easily influenced. This case is becoming a very interesting one. The fact that Bobby Brown Jr. was found alone in his home is very interesting, because if in fact he was not doing drugs, or if he was not into drugs, I can't imagine that he would be in his home by himself doing drugs and then just accidentally overdose. That just doesn't add up. So to me, it seems as if there is a possibility that either his girlfriend or some of his other friends or both were around him in that house when he passed away. Now, if in fact there were people in that home with Bobby Brown Jr. when he was having the overdose and no one bothered to call the police or call anybody out of fear because everyone was in there getting high, then whoever that was, those individuals definitely need to be held accountable for this. Just looking at Bobby Brown Jr. firsthand, he does not come off as somebody that was into drugs. I mean, he's always kind of been, you know, the quiet guy from what I can see. If you all remember, he was in Being Bobby Brown that was on Bravo TV back in the early 2000s, I believe, if I'm not mistaken. And it appears as if Bobby Brown Jr. was actually trying to follow in his father's footsteps. On his Instagram page, he was promoting a song that he had just released last year sometime, I believe, called Say Something. So it seems as if he was trying to, you know, be another future Bobby Brown. So for him to pass away at such an early age, in fact, he was only a few days shy of his 29th birthday, is just very, very sad situation. If we look at the timeline, it seems like every time we turn around, Bobby Brown is losing either a family or a loved one or someone that he knew behind drugs. We have obviously Whitney Houston, who was first, and then, you know, shortly after that, Bobby Christina. And then after Bobby Christina, her boyfriend, Nick Gordon, passed away. And then, and then the friend that was in the house with Nick Gordon and Bobby Christina as well passed away, all from drug overdoses. And now we have Bobby Brown Jr., who has unfortunately passed away from the same thing. Bobby Brown has asked for prayers for himself and for his family, and we will continue to report on this story as it develops. Smooches!